It doesn't really feel like you've wrecked your house. I mean, this feels like a gorgeous home.
It's just a really hard to figure out how to use the space for our family to all be together.
There is something about a house that doesn't work for you that is almost as bad.
Yeah, we've been trying to come up with ideas to remedy it.
Well, but it hasn't gone so well.
Yeah. I mean, you walk right in here. We've got plenty of room here, but then this gets a little tight, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little crowded.
What the couch doesn't fit.
What is this? Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Huh. You got brick and concrete. And the dust is legit. You don't want your kids to be breathing in dust, that's for sure.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
What are you thinking for the fireplace? Like, what's your dream?
I think really the fireplace has to go. It just comes out into the room too much. It drives me crazy.
But this room being so small, you can't even move around that way at all. And then the wall is really angled.
It's not even. This side's smaller than this side.
And so we pondered that, and Chelsea had the brilliant idea to try to knock it out. So I knocked this hole in. Once we saw the brick here and knocked out the brick there, we wonder if that's structural. So I'll try one more up a little bit higher. And sure enough, still bricks.
He wanted to keep going. I had to tell him to stop.
Yeah.
So this is like a micro cement look.
This whole style kind of doesn't even feel natural to the home. It feels very modern, or I'm not even sure what.
How would you describe your style?
I think the house and our style is more traditional, beachy kind of vibe.
What's this area over here? You hang out over here?
It really doesn't get used at all.
It's a big area.
Yeah, seems like a waste of space.
It's not until you start digging a little deeper that you start to realize the complexity of their problem, and that is the house doesn't work for them. Oh, this is cute.
Yeah, this is our kids' play area. Looks kind of messy all the time.
Like, this is a great place to play.
Yeah.
You use this space here as your dining room?
Yeah, we don't use it very often. We usually sit all up at the counter just because it's easier with the kids.
What's the tape on the floor? What's going on here?
Our biggest probably issue is
the kitchen.
The kitchen.
Okay.
I was trying to figure out if we wanted to maybe move it.
All right. Ambitious.
She gets up before me usually, and I'd come down the stairs, and my tape measure would be off my workbench, and she would be out here before the girls got up in the morning, because she had been thinking about it all night. This is rendition number 43. Maybe I am exaggerating, but it's a lot.
Most times you want to have a conversation and then put it to rest. Just having it hover and keep bringing it up only puts stress on us.
There's a frustration in not being able to solve this problem ourselves.
It's so tucked away from everything else of where we're at. I'm here, my back's to everybody. I'm washing dishes or prepping food, and the kids are over there, and it just cuts down the amount of time we have with them. Being able to talk to them is virtually impossible. So that's where we're at.
They've tried to do small temporary fixes, but deep down they know it's not gonna help the floor plan. So at the end of the day, they really haven't done anything. To make room for the kitchen, we have to remove the old patio door. We have to reframe and replace all of the windows. And what that'll do is it'll give us room for our new cabinets. And Mark and Chelsea, they're finally gonna have those sight lines that they've always looked for.
Made a lot of progress as far as our rough electrical. We have a lighting plan, so we've got all of our new lights figured out. As far as this fireplace, we're ready to frame. The hearth is gone, which is a big difference. We're gonna frame from that corner all the way over. It's gonna give them that nice squared off living room they're looking for. But this is what it's all about. This is the new kitchen, right? Before this was a dining area. They never really used it. Now we've got our windows in place. They're high enough so that our countertops can go underneath. They've got a great view of the backyard. Looks like a kitchen, right? Back here, this is all functional. Moving the kitchen gives me the opportunity to create more usable space and to just help this family stay organized. So we've got our pantry framed out. This room's gonna be the laundry room. We've got our broom closet, which is gonna have a door right here. This is just gonna be a really useful area for this family.
The fireplace is sitting on a load-bearing wall, so the only way to actually get rid of it is to square it off with framing. This will give room for a more functional space.
I think the two of you should go inside, have a look around, and I'll come find you in a few minutes.
All right,
yeah, let's go. So much fun. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, it looks great. Oh my goodness. It looks like a completely different space.
This used to be our non-sitting area, sitting area.
So crazy how different it looks, right?
The fireplace is gone.
Yeah, the fireplace is gone. Wow. And our kitchen's over here now. It's so different.
It is so different.
Now when we eat, we can hang out and I can cook. It can all be one space. It's beautiful.
You can actually see what everybody's doing.
I know. It looks so good.
Okay.
It looks amazing.
Yay!
I can't even believe it's the same space. It is crazy how you transformed it.
I cannot believe it.
It's crazy. You did an amazing job. Thank you.
Okay, let's go back to the front door. We're gonna walk through everything together because there's a lot to talk about. Okay, so the first thing I have to ask you, the floors.
I think they look amazing. I think it made it so modern.
So I wanted to keep the old floors, but I think it could not have came out better. Rarely will you hear me say it, hun, but I think I was wrong. I think they looked phenomenal.
It looks really good.
The other thing I have to ask you about is, do you miss the fireplace?
Not one bit.
No, not at all.
It definitely doesn't.
No, it feels like the space all works together, which is really nice. It feels like the style and everything is cohesive.
The living room.
Yes.
This area before.
Right.
You never used this space.
It was never a space that was really usable for our family.
Right.
But I feel like this is going to be great for Mark to watch football and hang out. It makes so much sense now seeing it.
If you'll remember, there was a pinch point right here. Remember? Like the couch came out and it was tight right here.
Yes.
Yep.
So now, I mean, making this into the dining area gave you enough space.
It looks so cute. I really like it. It's like an extension of the kitchen and it's right there. I think it makes a lot of sense.
So this little area now, I didn't really change too much. It's painted, it's cleaned up. But in my mind, like, this is still a kid's area. Just having the option now, I mean, your girls are getting older. I'm thinking homework, I'm thinking crafts.
Absolutely.
But to have the connectivity between this space and your kitchen means that you're gonna use it more than ever.
Yeah.
That makes a lot of sense.
All right, let's talk about this kitchen.
It looks so good. Yes. I can't even believe it. Love the islands.
The countertops are porcelain.
Okay.
Which means they're really durable.
Okay.
Open bottle of wine, olive oil. You are not gonna mess these up, which is nice.
That is definitely great for us. This is just such a great surface to entertain.
So you've got a new window.
Yes.
And then you've got your new windows here.
After dinner, the girls run back out to the backyard. And now if I'm finishing up the dishes or whatever after dinner, I can kind of see what they're doing and interact. So
That's huge.
That's huge.
You can see.
Yeah, I can see everything.
So if the kitchen is here.
Yes.
What do you think is back here?
No idea.
Let's go find out.
So excited. Right.
Even just having a hallway here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, a little sitting in like my room.
Wow, I love it.
Go ahead and open this door.
Oh, wow.
Oh my goodness.
So much storage, I love it.
This is where your fridge and those weird pull-out bins were
before. Yeah.
That's right.
Great storage spot.
It feels so weird that that's part of our house. Like that didn't exist before. Like what is behind those freaking doors, Jasmine?
Fair question. Okay, you wanna open this one?
Oh, wow. Laundry space?
Actually closed off.
You would come in from your garage and the laundry was here and you're stepping over it. It wasn't in a good spot.
It's great to have a dedicated space for the laundry. Like when people are coming in, they're not seeing it. It just feels so nice to close it off.
All right, last door.
All right, you ready for this one, then? Let's see what we have.
I'm excited. Oh, wow.
That
is so crazy. Especially for the girls to be able to get their food, not have to be reaching into a cabinet.
I don't have words. I do not have words.
I mean, a walk-in pantry is a game changer.
Yeah.
So these are three rooms that really didn't exist before.
Yeah, it's crazy to think that this is our kitchen before.
Yeah. Can you believe this is your house?
I'm ready to have a party, a dinner, a something.
Yeah.
Maybe a Sunday football, something, you know?
Yeah.
It's the connectivity as a family that really matters, right? You could have the most gorgeous house in the world, but if the floor plan doesn't allow you to be together, it's never going to be a happy time.